now invite Judge Dado to come forward to present a statement and to answer any questions that members of the commission may have.
Good morning. I am honored and humbled by much of what we have heard here this morning. I don't believe that there's anything I feel is necessary to add, but I would be happy to answer any questions that members of the commission might have.
Thank you, Madam Chief Justice. Judge Dado, thank you for being before us. I must tell you, this seems to be proceeding far differently from what I'm accustomed to in Washington, D.C. I'm happy for you in that sense, and to your wife, Debbie, and your family, I congratulate all of you for the work that you've all done to get Judge Dado where he is, because also having a family, I understand what it takes to get to this point. If you'll allow me to interject just for Ms. Kramer's sake, that the Department of Justice is there available if she has some matters she'd like to bring to the attention of my office. We will certainly consider that. We always will, and we always should. But to the matter at hand, Judge Dado, my sense is that what I took from Mr. Simon is that you have lots of faults. But then when I believe Judge Pressman mentioned that you eat cheap tacos, your stock went up. So at the end of the day, I think Judge Pressman was speaking to us when he talked about harmless error. So I think my questions, Madam Chief Justice, are very few, because I suspect we're in the realm of extremely harmless error if we look forward to the opportunity to elevate Judge Dado to the 4th District. So. Judge, I wish you the greatest of luck. I hope you continue to do things as a justice as you did as a judge to earn you such accolades. And I think at the end of the day, the people of California will be well served if that's the case. Thank you, Mr. Attorney General.
Presiding Judge.
Thank you, Chief. Judge Dado, I have no questions. Thank you very much.
Judge Dado, I have a question. I so rarely have an opportunity, but I wanted to ask you that I noticed in your background that not only have you worked for Justice Weiner, but you also worked for Justice DeBriner and Chief Justice Byrd. And I wanted to know how, if at all, those early experiences will shape you as an appellate justice.
Incredibly so. And I was going to, and I will comment on this perhaps in a few minutes in more detail, but it was really my experience as an extern first at the Supreme Court and then as a research attorney that convinced me that, first of all, appellate law, and secondly, the possibility of serving as a judge was something that I wanted to pursue in my career. And although at that point in time, we're talking about late 1970s, early 1980s, it was a long way off, it was something that so energized me, the work at the Supreme Court, that I knew at that point in time that it was something that I wanted to do later in life.
Thank you. You may resume your seat. I will let this